When Nazi Germany passed the Nuremberg Laws in 1935, they made it illegal for non-Germans to be citizens. Germans had to prove that they had Aryan ancestry. India's Citizenship Amendment Bill mirrors those Nazi laws. Instead of segregating people by genetics, it segregates people by religion. It makes religion the basis for citizenship. CAB is only the latest in a line of recent fascist actions in Modi's quote-unquote New India. It has been a grim year for India as the BJP rams through its Hindu nationalist agenda with blitzkrieg speed. After Modi was re-elected in May, he wasted no time in implementing the BJP's long-standing demands. That includes, to name a couple, enacting the National Register of Citizens in Assam, ultimately stripping nearly 2 million Assamese of citizenship. Modi's government is currently building concentration camps in Assam to house these newly made stateless people. Scrapping Article 370 in Jammu and Kashmir, Modi's government stripped the only Muslim-majority state in India of its semi-autonomous status, and then stole away its statehood. Kashmir remains under martial law right now, ever since August. Giving the green light to build a temple on disputed land in Ayodhya, and handing over the rights to do so to the same people responsible for the violent demolition of a mosque that once stood on that site. Now, a grim week concludes this grim year. After Modi's regime just passed CAB, the Citizenship Amendment Bill, the BJP's next goal is to pass a National Register of Citizens and implement it across the whole country. This puts all residents of India in the position of having to prove their citizenship. CAB and NRC combined provide a legal route for the BJP to begin cleansing the land of Muslims and, ultimately, of all non-Hindus. That's the goal of the BJP and of the Nazi-inspired RSS that controls the BJP. Calling the RSS Nazi-inspired is not a euphemism. Not only was the RSS founded the same year that Hitler wrote Mein Kampf, but its guru, a man called M.S. Govarkar, wanted to copy Nazi racial policies. When the Nazis staged pogroms against the Jews in Germany, Govarkar in India called it the highest form of race crime. He praised Nazi Germany for purging the country of Jews. He called the Nazi racial policies, the Nuremberg Laws, a good lesson for us to learn and profit by. The guru of the RSS said that any Indian who is not a Hindu is a traitor, and he called it treason to be a non-Hindu in India. Today, Modi calls that guru of the RSS as his own guru worthy of worship. Today, the current head of the RSS says that India is a Hindu nation. One of the final nails in the coffin of Indian secularism, God forbid, will be a national anti-conversion law. A law requiring people to receive government permission in order to change their religion, thus criminalizing religious freedom. In these grim times, hope is the one thing we must never give up, no matter how hopeless the situation seems. And this is my message to you today. stay filled with hope. Even blind, stupid, irrational hope. Because we know the truth. We know that Hitler always loses. As they say in Hindi, Jo Hitler ka raj karega, vo Hitler ki maat banega. Those who rule like Hitler will meet Hitler's end. Thank you.
Thank you.